What's happening, good people? It's Thursday Night Live fly tying, and these are the quick ties, and the season's almost over. So, I thought this week, this final week, the last two patterns, pattern 39 and 40, I would jump in the vice seat and get them tied up for you guys. So, I'm Dana Ladder with Fly Fishing Board for Outfitters and Thursday Night Live fly tying. It's emotional. It's emotional because if you're watching this, it's almost over. It is almost over. But we'll try to keep this on a bit of a happier tune as we tie a couple really cool patterns. And the first one that I want to walk you guys through on this quick tie is the Solomon Hair Wing Caddis. And I've been waiting to get over onto Tim's bench so that I have a camera that can focus on things like that. And so that's the fly that I'm going to be walking you guys through here. So if you want, you can grab the material lists off of our website at flyfishingbowriver.com/TNLS4. And you can get your materials and you can tie along with us too. But what we've done to make it really easy for you guys is... we've kind of put everything together here in a kit, which we call Season 4. There's still a bunch of kits left. You can go back and purchase them on our website at www.flyfishingbowriver.com/TNLS4. And in these kits, you're going to get all 40 patterns that we've already tied, whether you've watched the live streams or whether you've just joined us here on the Quick Ties. And we have all the materials kind of in the sample size set up in a kit so that you just have to pull them out and then follow along with this, which is super easy. So if you do have a kit, oh, this kit feels so empty. And that's because it is. The last one, the final one that we have in here for these kits is... Season 4, Episode 20. And in your kit in the back here, you can go in there and find the material bags for each of the flies. The one that we're going to be doing here is the Solomon Hair Wing Caddis. And that's the one with the oranges and the yellows. So with this pattern, and you just take all your kit and you lay it out and basically all your materials... come out. So just be careful when you are pulling them out because some people do fling them across the room and their hooks are kind of gone forever. So with this Solomon Hair Wing Caddis, change the colors if you want. Make it a fly that fishes in your area like your favorite caddis fly. And so in this one here, we're going to be kind of doing like the yellow ginger and then kind of more of a natural deer hair on top there. So what we're going to get started here. And if you are watching YouTube, because I also always wanted to do this all year, is make sure that you hit the like and subscribe button, hit the bell for notifications. That way, as we do put out videos, you're going to get notified as to the fact that they're live. And we do educational videos, we do fly tying videos, lots of really cool stuff. So make sure you do that. Also, leave a comment here. And let us know you're here. We call you guys the replay squad. So make sure you say, hey, what's up? Part of the replay squad here. And we're going to head over to the vise here. And essentially, we have a 6-0 in olive is what I'm using. Again, the colors really don't matter. They just have to kind of match the caddis that you guys, that you're wanting to fish in your area. So right here is kind of a size 16. Like a TMC 100 would kind of be a similar hook to this one here. So if you don't have it, like I said, the material list is on the website. And if you do have the kits, well, then you're just going to grab that hook that you got there and get going. So let's get that hook in the vise and get it secured up. And this is a very simple fly. It's just a couple materials. Not really any crazy skills to it, other than at the end the hackle can be a little pain in the butt to kind of tie in at the end, and we'll kind of see how that goes. So yeah, get the hook in the vise, get yourself some 6-0 thread, Or you can kind of use something else similar to that, like a 140 denier, that works too. So 6-odd thread in olive, getting ready to go on my hook. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna start it about a third of the way down. Remember, with these little dry flies or little nymphs, we don't want to really get too much thread like we would on a streamer, because it makes it bulky and then sometimes it's hard to get materials in there. So proportions wise, we're going to clip that off, the extra thread there, and we're kind of there. Tim would be really upset with this because probably that hook, I think it's pretty flat, but he gets... How about the nails? Is that an improvement? Let me know in the comments. So probably the tying isn't an improvement, but the nails are. And I always wanted to jump in here and tie with you guys. So it's kind of why I'm doing it here. So yeah, so the thread's going to hang here just kind of right around the barb. And that's pretty cool there. So everybody, what I was saying earlier was Tim really likes that hook to be super straight. And maybe it is, and maybe it isn't. So you got a lot of dubbing in your kit. And so we don't need a lot of dubbing, because it's not a very big fly. So what we need to do is kind of just pull some strands of this, kind of get a little thin and long. There's multiple kinds of dubbing, probably more of a dry fly dubbing like this would kind of make your noodle a little better. You can use wax if you like. I don't like to touch the wax because then I get wax on my fingers and then every other piece of this fly kind of goes to crap. So yeah, we're gonna get this on here. Maybe I just have a little too much even, because we don't need a lot. And so the trick here is to get this stuff corded up in a dubbing noodle. So I'm gonna say about a 3-inch. See how you can see? I don't know if it's there, but maybe it shows over there. It's not a lot, and a little goes a long ways. So as I get this corded up here, just the real key of that is that as you tie more of these, you're gonna kind of get the right amount down, so that when we do come back, we're gonna hit that 1/3 mark on our way back, and that's kind of why we started it there. So as we get going, work our way back with this dubbing. So the dubbing isn't like if you were to wrap or palm or something. So we just, as we wrap, we just have to make sure those wraps are getting that dubbing back to where they need to be. And your body can be however your body wants. And if you got extra and you want to work your way back, that's fine too. See, Tim's not on the music. I'm on the music, and apparently nobody's on the music. So choose, is that the body size you want? And that looks good to me, because I really don't want to go back in there and pluck a bunch out. But you could take your Velcro. We don't really need that to be super buggy there, but what you can do is you can pluck some of this out. So if you weren't happy and you were thinking that your body was a little too big, pluck a bit of that out, cut a little bit of that off. I find that's the easiest way to kind of thin that off. So body's good. We're back to the 1/3 mark. And essentially, we have two more materials to go, and then we're done. So in your kits, or if you don't have a kit, you're going to find yourself some natural coastal deer hair. And then you're going to go in and cut some of that off. And we are going to stack this deer hair, because we do want those tips to be super aligned. So how much do you need is a good question. Let's kind of take little, like, so there's the pencil and then there's the lead inside the pencil. And I'm gonna kind of go with the lead. I think it's more, what I like with about a caddis is their wings are big and they're kind of moth-like. So I don't think you're wrong if you got more, but again, there's the purists out there, and that's kind of up to you guys. So that's kind of how much I've chosen to do this. And so there's some under fur here that we're gonna kind of knock off. Also making sure everything that we're inviting to the deer hair stacker is there for the party to be stacked. So Deer hair stacker, you're gonna grab that. You're gonna grab the butt ends of this hair. You're gonna turn it around right about there. And we're just gonna slide them in there, and we're gonna tap it down. So a big thing with the deer hair stackers is that they can be full of static. If they do get full of static and you find they're, every time you pull it out, the hairs, it's not stacking well because of the static, or there's a bunch of hair that's got stuck in there before. What you can do is you can just take a piece of dryer lint, an anti-static device that we put in our dryers, and just fold it up and just kind of ream it through the deer hair stacker. And it works great for getting the static out of your deer hair stacker. Okay, so we're gonna really get this stacking down here. And then what we're gonna do is we pull this out. Oh, sometimes it goes, probably because of all the static that I thought I had out here earlier. But if that happens, that's not even a big deal, because you can just pull that stuff back out, go back in, put it back in your deer hair stacker. Or if you want, you just go cut yourself some more deer hair off there, because we're not really using a lot. And then my okay, so we got all our deer hair stacked. You can kind of see how much I've chosen to put on here. And so what we're gonna kind of do here is take, like, I'm measuring just basically the length of the shank of my hook. And then from that point, I'm gonna go back to the 1/3 mark. I'm gonna switch hands. And I'm gonna do a collecting wrap. Okay, we don't want that deer hair to slide and go all the way around the hook, but we do kind of want it to kind of curve around, so it creates a bit of that wing on our caddis there. So now I kind of got my deer hair set up like I like. Give it a little bit of tension there. Remember, cam, you've got yourself a small thread, so this is gonna break. So we go underneath and we wrap back just to really secure that deer hair, and then kind of pull out any of the pieces that we don't want. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a sharp angle, which you can't see because I'm cutting it with my finger facing the camera. Just kind of taper that off like that. And that's fine. And then we're just gonna kind of go back and wiggle through all those deer hair. Looks way better when you're not zoomed in. So then we're gonna work our way back. And if you wanna clean up any of those deer hair, now is the time to do it. It's also the time where you can't see what you're cutting, and you end up cutting your entire all the deer hair off. So we got our two materials in. We got our deer hair, however you prefer that wing to look is up to you. And then we've really just got one more item to put on here, or material, which is our hackle. And so we're gonna use like a golden straw, and I had the piece all the way over here for this kit, because, you know, this is sometimes what Tim goes through when his material falls off. So you guys do the same. Okay, I found my hackle right here, the piece of hackle, basically. So there's a shiny side and a dull side. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna have the shiny side facing us. So we're gonna pull a few of these barbs off the stem here. You're gonna kind of find the shiny side, and you're gonna put it towards you. But before we do this, why not just save our work? Because sometimes what happens here is the hackle is very slippery, and as you get it tied in, the hackle unspins on you, and then we won't lose our entire fly because we saved our work with a little half hitch and a half hitch tool. another cool thing about this bobbin is it comes right back to the fly. So let's tie in the stem here. And a shiny side facing us, and we're gonna do another half hitch, saving our work, and we're gonna come back, set our bobbin over there on the other side. Now we got some hackle pliers really help out with this, and we can grab our hackle here. And if you are gonna have trouble with this fly, it's gonna be in here. Okay, the really cool thing about a rotary vise is the precision at which you can start to wrap your hackle. Once it starts going, we're gonna give ourselves a couple spins, two or three. See how that hackle really wants to start sliding off of their fly there. So this is the part where you have to be really precise, careful about actually tying in your hackle and the fine line is tying it off and not having it come back. I like to use the half hitch here because it helps push all that hackle back. A couple half hitch will save your work or finish off your work. And then we just give ourselves a clip. The thread is free. And essentially, folks, that right there cleaned a few of those straggles out just for the aesthetics. The aesthetics of the fly. And I think I would fish that all day long. So again, with the deer hair wing, you can go bushier, you can go thinner, you can pull it back, however you deem appropriate for the caddis. That you can also pull some of those deer hair out of there, some are there. That, my friends, is the second last pattern, known as the Solomon Hair Wing Caddis, and that's episode 20 fly. That is a quick tie. This is a really great pattern for caddis. Once you find the pattern you love for caddis, I find that you don't need too many different patterns, perhaps different colors like this we talked about. You can have different body colors with the dubbing. You can change up the deer hair, and you can change up the hackle on the front there to change things like that. But that's the Solomon Hair Wing Caddis. That is quick tie. That is pattern 39 from episode 20 of season 4. And until next time, cheers.